Thank you for joining today's session, in which you will learn how to create custom assessments with Compliance Manager that are tailored to your business's unique compliance scenario. We understand that your organization may have compliance requirements that extend beyond the Microsoft 365 product space or the regulations and frameworks that we offer, and have built this functionality to ensure that you can use Compliance Manager to holistically track your compliance work. Here we are on the Compliance Manager homepage, where you can assess your compliance posture quickly with your compliance score. Once configured, this score will illustrate your progress against the set of regulations and standards that you have chosen based on their relevance to your organization. Your compliance score consists of points, which you achieve by taking recommended actions to improve your compliance. You're also given points based on the actions that Microsoft has taken on your behalf as your cloud service provider. In our last video, we showed you how to set up our out-of-the-box assessments to get your organization's most accurate compliance score. Setting up custom assessments is a great way to continue on that journey and make sure your compliance score is most relevant to the regulations that your company is subject to. Clicking into our new assessment template tab, you can see over 150 out-of-the-box assessment templates that we offer, each containing actionable recommendations specific to Microsoft 365. As a quick refresher, an assessment template is the starting point for an assessment, representing all of the control information and action recommendations for the regulation or framework mentioned. However, it's only by creating an assessment from the assessment template that you unlock the ability to start recording your progress against those actions and receive a compliance score based on your work. For example, if you want to evaluate yourself against SOC 1 for Microsoft 365, the SOC 1 assessment template in Compliance Manager shows you the control framework for that standard, gives you a detailed view of how Microsoft implemented and tested actions that are part of its responsibility as cloud service provider, and provides step-by-step guidance on how to improve your compliance by taking actions to implement controls that are your responsibility as per the SOC 1 standard. If that's all you need, it's very simple and straightforward to create the assessment and complete your work. However, if your organization has unique compliance requirements that require additional customization, our custom assessment functionality can be used to help meet your specific compliance needs. The two most common custom assessment scenarios are to add new controls and actions to an existing out-of-the-box assessment template, or to create a brand new assessment template to evaluate your compliance against a specific regulation or use case that we don't support today. For that latter case, you can even export and incorporate components of our existing out-of-the-box assessment templates. This is particularly useful if you track against a custom compliance framework that draws on several existing regulations or frameworks that we already offer. Alternately, you can take our existing control mapping and recommendations for a regulation as applied to the M365 product space and expand them to other products that are already relevant to you. For the sake of this demonstration, I'll walk you through the process of adding new controls and actions to one of our existing assessment templates in a process we call extending a template. To make this easy for you, a wizard will walk you through the process, providing step-by-step guidance. Since we're extending an existing out-of-the-box template, we'll want to have one in mind before we start. Browsing through the assessment template library is a great way to figure out what our starting point will be. We can even export these templates to Excel, where they will closely approximate the format we'll need during the custom template creation process. Once we've decided what template we'll be using as a starting point, we'll choose to create a new template. Then we'll choose Extend a Microsoft template and choose the template that we'll be using as our base. In this case, we'll choose ISO 27001. We'll also want to click on Download the sample file to take a closer look at the format we'll be using to add new actions and controls in just a moment. Once we have chosen what template we want to extend, the next step is to provide an Excel sheet containing the relevant template, control, and action details we want to add to Compliance Manager. Remember, since we're just extending an existing template, everything we put in this Excel sheet will be added to the out-of-the-box assessment template that we already selected. if we want to edit that base ISO 27001 template, we would instead export it, make edits inline, and re-import as a new custom assessment template. But that's a topic for another video. For now, let's hop into Excel to take a closer look at what we'll be adding. The first tab, Template, contains the metadata that you'll use to define the title, relevant product and certification, and covered services for your custom assessment template. This is a great place to call out that this is an extension of an existing template, and to specify any new products or services that you might be adding as part of the extension process. Next up is the tab Control Family, which contains all of the information about the controls that you want to add in this template, including their name or identifier, title, description, and control family or control area grouping. This tab is also used to map actions to controls using the Control Action Title column. This is a critical piece of your custom assessment template, as it tells Compliance Manager which actions relate to which controls. Remember, one action can contribute to the completion of multiple controls, and you can even reference actions that already exist in other out-of-the-box or custom assessment templates. Just add the action title in this column, and remember to use double semicolons to delimit the list of actions. Finally, we get to the Actions tab. This is where you'll add any new actions that you want as part of this template, and specify their various attributes, including how they are implemented, what their score is, their description, and any additional dimensions that you'd like for action sorting. Remember that an action's title is its unique identifier. You can't have two actions with the same title, so if you reference an existing action here but change its attributes, Compliance Manager will attempt to make those edits when you import this Excel file. In fact, if you want to include an action that already exists in Compliance Manager today, whether it is part of an out-of-the-box assessment template or you previously created it as part of a custom assessment template, you don't even need to list it here. You just have to include its title in the action mapping column for any controls that you want it to be related to. Once we've finished with this Excel file and imported it, we'll receive confirmation that the file is valid, as well as a summary of the items we're about to import. In case you made a mistake, Compliance Manager will provide any applicable error messages, as well as a copy of your Excel file with inline highlighting and error details to help you quickly resolve any issues. Once we complete our import, we can hop into the template in our new template drill-down view, which highlights all of the various components of your template. You'll notice here that there is no status, because you haven't actually started working on an assessment. You've only set up an assessment template. To take that next step, you can use the Create Assessment button and start getting to work. With more than 220 updates every day from 1,000 regulatory bodies around the world, we know it is challenging to keep up to date with the evolving compliance landscape. All of our Compliance Manager assessments are kept up to date as changes take effect on a given regulation or standard. This capability helps you stay ahead on regulatory changes, as well as offering the flexibility of whether to immediately take changes into your assessments or postpone them to the most opportune time. We hope you found today's session on configuring custom templates helpful. To learn more about our out-of-the-box template configuration, please tune into our other deep dive session. Thank you for listening and have a good day.